Hey, what's up YouTube? Hutch with Hutch Boat Farms here. Had a client reach out to me and liked our bed build video and decided they wanted to build something similar. So in this video, I'm going to build another mid-century modern live edge bed. So the materials I used in this build is actually the white oak from the barn teardown I did. So I'm going to recycle and repurpose those materials and then some maple slabs that I had.
So the build process always starts at the drawing board where I brainstorm exactly what I want the piece of furniture to look like. Once I have everything drawn up, I then start working with my spalted maple slabs. This slab is wider than it really needs to be for the footboard, so I start by ripping a straight edge along the bottom. That'll help me square up the ends when I go and make those cuts. The hardwood supplier, for some reason, wrote on this slab with a Sharpie, so before I go too far, I'm going to make sure it sands off. So now I begin the same process with the headboard slab. This slab's a little more tricky just because it'll be left the way it is. It won't have a straight edge. So I need to reference each end of the slab to the other to make sure it's square. As you can see, I'm using my woodpecker's square here to make sure I'm pulling my tape measure straight across the slab. This is some added peace of mind to help me get everything square, but also gives me a good visual on what the slab will look like in the headboard. Now that I have the headboard and footboard slabs cut to dimension, it's time to mill up some lumber. So I am repurposing the white oak from the barn that I tore down. This is a labor-intensive process. It starts with me pulling all the nails, then running the boards through the joiner on two sides. From there, it goes to the planer on the third side and then back through the table saw. So when working with recycled hardwood, you always have added steps to the process. This is not grade A lumber, and what I mean by that, it has a lot of imperfections, a lot of knots, a lot of cracks. So as a builder, you have to work with those, and you'll see I'm going back to the miter saw to cut the lumber to the sizes that will work with those imperfections in the wood. During my last project, I noticed that I was getting a lot of snipe from my planer, so I'm going to start this project by leveling my infeed and outfeed rollers on my planer to help eliminate that snipe. To do that, I'm just using a straight edge across each rollers with the table to make sure everything's coplanar. That quick little adjustment didn't fix it completely, but it did put it within tolerances, so I moved forward. These barn trusses started out as 8/4 material, and what that means is 2 inches thick. After I joined and planed everything down, I was left with about 1 3/8 inches just from eliminating all the warp in the wood. It's a long process to mill up this much lumber. I sure do wish I had some help. I guess I should make wishes more often. Here my wife is lending a hand by helping mill up some lumber. With the big planer out of commission, we pulled out the smaller planer to get the job done. Once the boards have went through the joiner and planer, it was off to the table saw to cut that fourth straight edge. The wife was excited to try out the new Laguna saw.
Okay,
I was happy to lend a hand to get the dust off of her.
I think you need a better dust collector.
With the helper back in the house taking care of the little one, I then ripped the rest of the boards. This sliding fence has quickly become one of my favorite features of the Laguna saw. It makes it really quick and easy to make accurate cuts when cross-cutting with this saw. Finished dimension when we're all said and done milling up these wood trusses from the old barn is going to be 1 3/8 inches thick by 3.5 inches wide. Another use for this sliding fence is when you're trying to rip longer pieces, you can pull it back to have more fence before the blade. And this makes it easier to make a more accurate cut. The longer pieces for the headboard and footboard, I'll cut to final dimension at the miter saw. I just check for square after each cut. I also pay special attention to the wood and where those imperfections and knots are at, just to try to eliminate and cut those out where I can. Once everything is cut to dimension, I sand everything down to 120 grit, and then it's off to the Festool domino joiner to do some loose tenons. Like I've said in some earlier videos, I'm kind of in the middle with the Festool domino joiner. It's a really nice tool, it's just awfully expensive. But what I did recently after this project was double down on the domino joiner and actually purchase some accessories from Seneca Woodworks to make my domino joiner a little more useful and user-friendly. Here I'm going to rip the spalted maple slab to final dimension. This will make it so it's the right size to fit inside my footboard. Then I sand the slab to 120 grit. Each piece of this bed will actually be sanded to 120 grit twice, with the water popping in the middle. The headboard and footboard has live edge on it, so I'm sanding the live edge just to make it smooth. A little bit more gradual of changes, just to keep it from snagging on linens or anything like that. I cut a dado into the bottom rail of the footboard that will accept the spalted maple slab. So to glue up this footboard, I'm using the domino joiner along with the biscuit joiner. This footboard slab was actually a little bit thinner than the headboard slab, so I didn't want to use my dominoes to fasten it on each end, so I decided to use the biscuit joiner for this application. Big glue ups like this is always a little intense. You're trying to get everything together before anything sets. Once everything was together, I actually countersunk some screws into the bottom rail of the footboard into the bottom of the maple slab just to add a little bit more rigidity to it. I learned from my last bed build that I needed some longer pipe clamps, so I went out and purchased 3. Probably needed more than that, but they're pretty expensive. And here's what the footboard looks like once it's glued up. Here I am ripping the white oak to final dimension for the headboard. When I talked earlier about the added processes to use recycled lumber, this is another example. Trying to cut out imperfections on one side of the wood or the other, you make multiple passes before you get to that final dimension, just to eliminate it all. Here I am just showing my brute strength. I sand all the pieces again to 120 grit before using my domino joiner and placing those loose tenons. I found that this will help with the accuracy of the domino joiner. And now I'm laying out where those loose tenons will go. I'm also arranging the recycled lumber to where the nail holes will actually be on the back of the headboard. When laying out the positions of the loose tenons, I'll actually draw little ovals in the spots where I'll cut them just to keep from making the wrong cut. The headboard slab had a rough sawn look on the backside, so I started with 60 grit and got rid of most of those rough sawn marks and then moved to 120 grit. During the dry fit, I will glue in the dominoes into the ends of the headboard rails. This will help just have one step done before final glue up. And if anybody has tried to pull a domino out of a piece of wood, you know how frustrating and difficult that can be. Now I'll place the maple slab inside the headboard. This will help me line everything up and plan to where the dominoes will go to attach the slab to the headboard frame. Once all the loose tenons are cut, it's time for the challenge of the final glue up. During this project, I used a glue brush during my glue ups, and I have to say that I had a lot less mess and a lot less squeeze out with this method. When gluing up big pieces like this, it really makes you wish that you had a larger space to get the job done and more longer clamps to squeeze the wood together. This video shows me clamping in three different positions, but that really wasn't the case. Over about 15 minutes, I actually clamped in multiple spots, tightened it down, brought the wood together, unclamped, and then clamped in a different spot, just to assure everything's square and tight fitting. So here's the headboard and footboard out of clamps all glued up, and I've actually already added the wood filler to both of them. Now on to the bed side rails. For these, I'm actually milling up the same 3.5 inch wide pieces of white oak from the trusses, and then I'll join both of these together. I cut them to rough length, won't cut to final dimension until they're out of clamps and all glued together. Because of the imperfections in the wood and just the slight warp I may have, I decided to use the domino joiner to glue these together, not really needing the added strength, just to keep them aligned and looking like one piece of wood. I put both of them together and then they go into clamps together. To avoid warp, it's important to put clamps on the top and the bottom of the pieces of wood. This will help keep even pressure on both sides. I then pull the bed rails out of the clamps, cut them to final length, and then rip them to final dimension of about 6 inches wide. I went around the entire bed frame with a 3/8 inch roundover bit. I recently switched from a Festool trim router to this Milwaukee M18 cordless trim router, and I've really been happy with it. It is a little difficult to switch out the bits for some reason, but overall it's been a nice change. After putting wood filler in the bed rails, I then sand them down to 120 grit, followed by water popping it and then sanding at 180 grit. After everything's been water popped and sanded down to 180 grit, I then wipe everything down with mineral spirits to get all the dust off of it. Rubio Monocoat 2-part oil finish and chocolate will be the color finish for this project. Wipe it on, let it sit for about 15 minutes, and wipe it back off. This has been a fun project, and it's neat to see this old barn wood be repurposed for a nice piece of furniture that will hopefully last a long time. Here's what the headboard and footboard looked like after stain. I left the nail holes in the wood. I just liked how it looked and the character added. Now time for a dance party.
Hi.
Well, I hope you enjoyed that. If you did, please like, share, and subscribe. And also check the rest of my playlist out for other videos like this.
Remember, faith, family, future. Build yours.
Thanks. Have a good one.